Hey there, chameleons! It's Camille, and today I'm going to show you guys how I bleached my hair from this brown color to a very, very light blonde in order to do a pastel pink on top, because a lot of you guys have been asking how I was able to get my hair that light and how you could do it too, and I'm not a hairdresser, this is just my personal method. So first, you gotta put on your gloves because we're dealing with chemicals today, and then pick a bleach. I really like L'Oreal Quick Blue, which is why my bucket is almost empty at this point. And then I do about 3 scoops at once, and then I'm adding in the ion sensitive scalp protector because I have a mad soft scalp and I need some help. So this helps the bleach not burn it as much as it would if I just did regular bleach. I guess I'm just a softy, but now I'm using the 40 volume developer, also from the ion sensitive line, which is new. This is the first time I tried it, because that's the worst part about bleaching, and if I can get rid of that, then I am happy. So you want to fold that in together so that the dust doesn't go all over the place, and then you thoroughly mix it together. I'm adding a little bit more because I need a lot of bleach to cover my whole head, so I always do it based on how much hair I have at the time. I'm also using the Ion Absolute Perfection Kit. This is step 1, and it's pretty much Ion's dupe for Olaplex, and it's a lot more inexpensive, and that's why I used 40 volume developer, because it brings it down to equal about 30 volume. So this is my hair. This is what we're starting with. My regular brown color with some bleached tips from the last time I colored my hair. So pretty much I'm sectioning off every part of my hair that's like framing my face, kind of. So like the front, the sides, and I'm tying those off because I'm gonna be doing those last since they're a little bit thinner than the rest of my hair, as well as the hair at the nape of my neck because that hair is also very thin and lightens way quicker. So I'll be saving those for last. For the rest of my hair, I'm dividing that into 2 sides. Got that bleach all ready to go, so now I'm sectioning each section into smaller sections so I can make sure that it's very even. And I'm painting on the bleach with about 1 inch to the scalp because I know it's gonna swell during the process. Then I'm going to be using my hands to pretty much just spread the rest of that out, because it's a lot easier. And I tried to avoid the edges, which are already bleached, but eventually I got them, but it's okay because I'm cutting them off anyways. But yeah, pretty much just do the same thing for that whole side of your head, just making sections and making sure that each section is very saturated from the front and the back, because you don't want it to be patchy. So this is what it looks like when it starts swelling up. But now I'm doing the back of my head, and I'm doing that all by hand because it's so much easier to feel back there than it is to paint, so that's all just from feeling. Now I'm doing the front of my head, and since this is the last part that bleaches really quickly, I'm just doing it all the way down to the root, and I'm using the brush to make sure all of the edges are completely saturated. I don't want the front pieces of my curls to get too damaged, so I save it for last because it also can't stand the same amount of time as the thicker pieces of hair, but that's just how I do it. It's up to you. You know your hair best. I also like to saran wrap my head so I can keep the bleach and the heat in so it can process faster and easily without drying out too quickly. And here is what I look like with plastic wrap on my head. I'm an alien, but we already knew that. And then this is what it comes out looking like after 1 bleach. It's a light yellow, and that's when you know it is time for round 2. So this is what my hair looked like after a 2nd round of bleaching. So now I am popping those gloves on and doing my Blonde Brilliance toner. I'm using the one in lilac. They have a few different shades, but as you know, I was going pink and purple, so I decided why not get that extra kick that's keeping it a little bit cooler. And then I used the Blonde Brilliance developer as well, and it's only a 5 volume developer. It's not very damaging. The whole thing actually feels kind of conditioning. So you can use a brush to spread it, but honestly, that's not how we're trying to do it over here. I'm using my hands because it spreads like liquid. It's so easy, and I'm just making sure it's even by sectioning it. Even though it spreads very easily, I just want to make sure that all of my hair is thoroughly saturated, like I said 8 times earlier in this video. But it's very important because it makes your hair as even as possible, especially when you're doing stuff at home. So it looks purple, but when you rinse it out, your hair is just cool toned. So this is what my hair looked like. I know it's not exactly perfect, but I just needed it light enough so I could do the pastel color on it and this is how it turned out. Between all of the different measures I took, I feel really happy with the curl pattern I'm left with, and when you go out into natural light, you can see that it looks a lot more even and lighter for some reason, not really sure. But I really loved how the blonde looked on me, and I was just doing it so I could do pink hair, but your girl kind of fell in love with it, so I kept it for like a week and a half and had a lot of fun with it. You know, blondes have more fun. But yeah, so that's how I got my really dark hair really light with minimal damage in order to color my hair pastel pink. The link for that video is in the description box, as well as all of my social media that you should definitely check out if you like this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I wish you all a happy, healthy life, and I will see you chameleons in the next one. Kisses! Mwah.